Hey YouTube, this is Bad at Games, and I'm here today doing a pack opening, box opening, lots of box opening, actually. So what I've got here is Synchro Storm, and what you're probably going to be saying to yourself is, "Hey, Bad at Games, isn't that like a really, really, really old box?" The answer is, yeah, a little bit. But with the popularity of Baron de Fleur and a couple cards out of the set that I personally want to pull, I decided it was time to do it. And while I have never. Okay, what you should know is that I've never actually opened this many cards before in my life. This is a totally new experience for me. Even though I was a fan of Yu-Gi-Oh! As a kid, I've never actually opened more than like a couple of packs at a time or a couple structure decks. So this is so far beyond the norm for me that I am very excited to be doing this today. So without any further ado, I'm going to break into these boxes. And we're gonna get started. Wow. Now that I'm looking at them all on the table, this might actually be more cards than I've ever owned before collectively. What I learned really early on in Yu-Gi-Oh! Was that a lot of times when you want specific cards, it only pays to go out and buy the single. It doesn't make any sense to go and open packs. And so I did my homework before I went ahead and bought all of these, but man, looking at them on the table, I think this pile of cards here is more than I had ever previously owned combined. And again, I can't get over how exciting this is for me. That this feels like a childhood dream come true. So I am really, really excited about this. I'm glad that I did it. I'm gonna go ahead and get into it now. And before I get too far, though, I probably should mention where these came from, how I got them. I bought these on TCG Player, and they came from Core TCG, which I'm sure that if you've ever used TCG Player before, you've probably noticed them selling things before. So far, the experience has been pretty good. The package was in good shape when it arrived. All the boxes inside looked fine. A couple of the boxes, the individual boxes of cards, looked like maybe they had been crushed a little bit at one point. Nothing like severe or anything, but just that maybe it's something you had set them down wrong or grabbed them wrong or something along those lines. Also, people are going to wonder why the gloves. It is hot. It is humid. It is Tennessee in the middle of summer. So I'm going to go ahead and do this just so that, like, if somebody else was opening cards that I went and then bought, I would want to know that they took the very best care possible of those cards. So that's what I'm trying to do here. I'm using gloves because I want you guys to see how I would personally want my cards to be taken care of. And then by extension, that if you choose to buy a card from this set that I'm about to open, then I would want you guys to see exactly how good of care I take care of them. I think it's very important. So without any further ado, we're going to get into it. I want to start with this pack that was a little bit damaged. You can tell, like, it's not real damage. It looks like a factory thing happened. But anyway, let's get rolling. I don't want to sit around here all day long talking about it. All right, this is very exciting for me. OG Synchron Explorer, that's cool. So we are opening packs of five cards, and we already are finding Lyrilisk, Sight Assembled Nightingale. That's cool. We're probably going to be pulling enough Lyrilisk cards and everything to be able to make a box by the end of the day. So what we're going to do is start setting stuff aside. These are rares. These are commons. And yeah, I've got sleeves and everything for higher rarities, so that way we can go ahead and immediately sleeve those if we see anything. What's funny to me actually is I was kind of worried that the gloves would get in the way. I've never tried to open a pack of cards this way, but they're actually working really nicely. But we've got our Speedroid stuff, Fleur Synchron, very exciting for me. So one of my recent projects has been to put together a Yusei Fudo deck that's accurate to the anime. Ooh, look at that. We're getting some fluff coming off of the packs of cards, which I guess I'm not completely surprised by, but it's a little disquieting nonetheless. But anyway, let's take a look at what we're getting. Stardust Assault Warrior, very cool pull. I mean, obviously we're going to pull a bunch of them, but it's still fun. Fancy. Kite Drake. Stardust Warrior. I love that card. Ooh, we pulled our first super. Very nice. And then Synchro Dilemma. Okay, so that's our first foil card out of the set, which is very exciting to see. I mean, we're gonna see a bunch of them, I get it, but it's still fun in the context of what we're doing today. So I mentioned before that we are aiming for Baron de Fleur, and that's cool and all. The question is, how many do we pull? I think it's basically guaranteed that we're going to see a handful of them today. But can't get too far ahead of yourself. Ooh, Chevalier. That's a fun card. What am I doing here? I think that was, yeah, that's a super. Don't want to get things mixed up too badly. Like I was saying before, it's actually kind of funny. I really thought that the gloves would make this more difficult, but actually they've got a really good grip to them. Ooh, Tornado Dragon. Building a deck actually that needs one of these, so maybe I'll even set one of those aside. But looking through. And Totem Bird, okay. Yeah, we really are seeing a little bit of dust and stuff coming out of these packs, which is kind of interesting. Obviously, they were still factory sealed with the plastic, but I never would have guessed that that was a thing. So, kind of interesting. I don't know if that's from the card cutting process or what it is, but anyway, kind of interesting to see. And another Fleur Synchron. Ooh, okay, here we are. Here's our first Ultra. Lyrilisk Bird Call. Very fun. If you're going to build the deck, then you definitely want to see a couple of those. I'll show you over here as well. Very exciting. What's kind of fun to me, as somebody who has not opened a lot of Yu-Gi-Oh cards in the past, I know I've said that a bunch of times, but I think that you're going to find that that's really the case, is that they don't replace the rare with the ultra or the super or whatever the case may be. It's actually seems to be an addition to the guaranteed rare. So that's cool. The Tornado Dragon. Okay. Speedroid Duplication. That could be fun. What's kind of unfortunate about this box, I suppose, is that it doesn't seem like there's a ton of extra deck support for the Speedroids. So that's kind of a thing. But anyway, let's see, two Synchros pulled out of this one. That's kind of fun. More duplication. So what I mean by like not a whole lot of extra deck support is like if you wanted to go ahead and make your Speedroid deck, you couldn't just with this box, having looked over what its contents are, but we'll see. Assembled Nightingale, another copy of it. Even though Lyrilisks, at least you'd have something to go into, even though it's a rank one. Though I don't really know much about the deck. With this much support being pulled for it, though, it might be a lot of fun to try and finish the deck. So we'll see. If we get to that point and we're doing that, then I'll definitely post a video, a follow-up. All right, let's get rid of these first batches of sleeves. Pretty Fleur de Fleur and Synchro Dilemma. That's a very nice looking card. No idea what it does, but it's gorgeous. We'll set that aside. Another Chevalier. This one seems to be fighting us a little bit. Interesting. It is actually really fighting us, this particular pack. You can see it's also sealed a little bit off center, so that. No, it looks good from that side. I don't know. Have to get into it as though we were kids and didn't know how to open packs. There we go. Another Synchro Dilemma. We're seeing a bunch of those. That seems to be a very common card in the set. The Katara and another and a Speedroid Wheel. Very nice. Ooh, okay, here we are. Here's definitely an ultra Lyrilisk assembled ensembled Robin. That's fun. That's a very fun pull. Probably not worth anything, but very, very fun. And another copy of Nightingale. Very nice. Clear Wing Rider. Gorgeous card. There's our next Ultra. Very nice. Penance of Revolution. Interesting. Continuous trap card, probably not very good, but that's fine. Speed lift, interesting. Ooh, Celestine Wagtail, very nice. Very pretty card. Looks like we might be able to finish those Lyrilisks after all. I mean, especially with so much of the pile left. But that's just all very exciting for me. Red-Eyed Dice. Okay, we've not seen that one yet. Ooh. This is our first really big pull. Crystal Clearwing Synchro Dragon. Very nice, very handsome card. Absolutely going to keep one of those for myself. Not the most expensive card anymore, but it is just a very exciting find for me personally that I'm really, really glad it's in the set. It was one of the big motivators, actually, for the set, is knowing that Crystal Clearwing comes as a ghost, actually, in the set. So that is one of my target cards for today. Yeah, but what an exciting find. Love it. Even if it's not worth a whole lot, it's about how much fun it'll be down the road. Another Flordelis. And I'm so glad it's in the set. I think it's really cool. All right, moving along. Interesting, Bird Sanctuary. We have not seen this one yet. It'd be nice. Kite Drake. That one opened really easily. It was ready to go. Maybe that means it's exciting to show us what's going on inside. Apparently not, though. That's fine. We have got a mountain of cards in front of us to work through. Nice, another Bird Sanctuary. Ooh, we have not seen one of these. Ultra Hound, super rare, very cool. Celestine Wagtail, nice. And another Chevalier. Starting to make some progress in this pile, actually. Ooh, Necrosynchron as an Ultra. Very nice. Another Ultra Hound, cool. Ooh. Nice. And we've got Corkshooter here. Another Ultra. We've not seen that one yet. Very nice pull. Had me all excited there for a second. Thought it might be a copy of Barone, but that's how they get you. Sorry about that. I've seen so many unboxing videos where people just take the packs and throw them all over the floor. And while funny, I've decided to open up a new trash bag, so all of my trash is together today. Anyway, ooh, that's a Synchro Monster. Oop, I saw something in there. Clearwing Synchro Dragon. Very nice. That's a fun pull. That's another really, really fun pull. Love to see it. Ooh, a second copy of Clearwing Synchro Dragon. That is so cool. My favorite card in the game is actually Stardust Dragon. And I adore it. But all of the Clearwing cards kind of speak to me on the same wavelength as Stardust, I suppose. Originally, I started really getting into Stardust Dragon because of Yu-Gi-Oh! 5Ds. And Yusei Fudo, specifically, I think, was just such a strong character that I couldn't help but get invested in the card. The funny thing, though, is that that wasn't always the case. The very first time, well, okay, not the very first time that I bought cards ever, but when 5Ds was coming out and Stardust Dragon had just been released, it was released alongside Red Dragon Archfiend. And so my sister and I, we both bought a tin of cards featuring one of the two dragons. And I bought the Red Dragon Archfiend set, and I was kicking myself the whole time afterwards, once I realized how much more I liked Stardust. But as you know, how kids are being a little bit too competitive, I would say, I thought that 500 attack points would be the difference. And anybody who plays those cards nowadays can tell you that is that's not the case. That's kind of a juvenile take. But you know, I was a kid, maybe 10 years old at the time. So either way. All right. Ooh, that's something we haven't seen yet. White Steed of the Floral Knights. We have not found one of those yet. Another Wagtail. Very nice. Nice. We have not seen. Actually, I think we have seen one of those already. Maybe one or two. Promenade Thrush. I don't actually think we've seen one of these yet. That's exciting. Always happy to pull a super. There's never a bad time to pull a super, let me put it that way. Sauge de Fleur. Sauge de Fleur. That's a fun card. Definitely a nice find. It's an ultra, looks very nice. Another bird call, very nice. We're definitely looking for three of those to make the play set. They're not a hard target, but they are nice. Like I said, when you have so much Leerlisk support for free, it's kind of hard not to think about making the deck. Another Speedroid wheel, very nice. And another bird call. Very nice. To my knowledge, that makes the set. Which, that's awesome. So we're starting to make it a way into this set, and I'm kind of surprised to have not seen a copy of Barone yet. I suppose I'll have to take a look in the post footage when I'm actually editing this whole thing to see how many packs I've gone through at this point, because I have not been keeping count. But it does seem like the overall count so far is kind of low, but we'll see. Okay, Drake, again. Here we are. There's another crystal clear wing. Very nice. Very exciting pull. Love to see him. Another bird call. Copy of a wheel. Ooh, there's a synchro, second to last, and Ensemble Robin, nice. Crystal Clear Wing, there's another copy. Very exciting. Still no Barone. I feel like we're getting a ways through this pile, which means we are a little bit behind, but we'll see. We'll see. Another Clear Wing, very nice. Did I say Chevalier earlier? Chevalier de Fleur? Because it's definitely Chevalier de Fleur, just for the record. Another cork shooter, very nice. There's another Clearwing Synchro Dragon. Always cool. Not complaining about finding that. So there's a lot of dust coming out of these packs, which is kind of an interesting thing to see, but oh well. Let's keep moving. Oh, what have we got here? Another Clearwing Rider. Nice. Definitely a cool card. But we've got a long way to go. Another clear way. Noble Knight. Interesting. Quick drink of water, very important. All right, another cork shooter. I guess that's one way to open it. Ooh, here we are. Another crystal clear wing. About time we found something in here. Dang, those are shiny. Let's move them out of the sun just a little bit, shall we? So at this point, I'm pretty confident that we should have pulled Barone already. It's starting to get kind of worrisome that it might be a lot more rare than what the material out there might suggest. But we'll see. We'll see. faintness a little bit. Ooh, pulled something. Hey, there he is. There's Baron de Fleur. Oh my gosh, I was starting to worry that they stopped printing it or something. Check that out. That's gorgeous. That is the target card of the set. One of two anyway, but that is quite the pull. That is absolutely lovely to see. That is why we are here today, I would go so far to say. Actually, that's not even going all that far to say it. That's literally true. Let me grab a sleevey boy for it, just so it's not sitting out at all. And then we're going to find out that even though these gloves are great for cards, they're not so great on sleeves. But anyway, straight into the sleeve. Nobody has touched it. If you think about it that way, nobody has had a chance to put a fingerprint on it. You will be, if you choose to buy one of these cards, you will be the very first. That is a gorgeous card. Gorgeous pickup. Very glad to see that today. And we will set that aside. Very nice. That's nice, because I was starting to get really worried that like Konami or something just wasn't printing them anymore. But no, to see that's a really, really nice pull. That's a little stretch. A little extra water. One Barone so far. And a couple other really nice cards. So at this point, we are looking for more copies of Barone. And we are looking for the Ghost Rare, Crystal Clear Synchro Dragon. That is the other really big ticket today. Obviously, we'd like to find a handful of both, but I think realistically, we are on track for one or two of the Ghosts and a couple more copies of Barone. And if we do that, then I think we'll be in pretty good shape. Oh, well, let's see. Hey, there he is. There he is. That is copy number two, Baron de Fleur. That is another gorgeous copy. Let y'all take a look at it. That's number two. Very nice. I don't think I showed this camera the first time. There you are. Number two, Baron de Fleur. That's gorgeous. I'm gonna go ahead and sleeve that up, just like the others. That's gorgeous. I am so happy to see it. That is two off now of Baron de Fleur. Absolutely phenomenal pulls. Each one is worth about $130 right now. So each one that we find is goes a long way to making my girlfriend happier that I bought so many Yu-Gi-Oh cards. But anyway, still very, very, very cool finds. Another Clearweed Synchro Dragon. We have not seen one of those in a while, but very nice. I love the card personally. And I know it's not the most expensive card in the world out there, but I think it's just such a cool find that I don't even mind. Another Clearwing Synchro Dragon. Very, very nice. Nothing there. Time for a little more water, I think. Oh, another clear wing rider. Nice. Always happy. Always a good thing to see those. Man, there are a lot left. And there's another clear wing. Very nice. Love it. Ooh, there we are, another ensemble robin. Stay, stay. Stay. All right. I don't know why, but that one was really trying to run away. Very nice. Hey, there it is. That is copy number three. We officially have a play set. Look at that. Isn't that just a gorgeous card? Baron de Fleur. Love to see it. We love to see that. Absolutely fantastic. Let's get that sleeved right away. Because there is no reason to leave this thing out open to the air or dust or anything else that might be around. Gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous pull. That is our third copy. And as exciting as that is, we have still not seen a ghost rare of Crystal Clearwing Synchro Dragon. That is the last target on our list. Obviously, more copies of Barone would be lovely. Would not complain in the slightest. But that's what we're looking for at this point. Clear Wing Synchro Dragon. We love it. Add it to the stack. Oh, we missed a couple. Well, let's take a look anyway. Ooh. Okay. So this is not going to be a fancy one coming out of here, but two more commons. They don't hurt. Kind of nice to have. Oops, set those in the wrong pile there. Oh, I just realized I mixed together some comments into the rares again. Oh well. I'll pull this out later. Oh. Hey, there we are. That is exactly what we've been looking for. That is the Ghost Rare Crystal Clear Wing Synchro Dragon. What a gorgeous find. Wow, that's something. That is absolutely marvelous. Wow. Check that out. That's nice. That's a gorgeous find. Wow. Yeah. It's stuff like that that we're here today for. Wow, that is amazing. Well, we've officially found all of our target cards. At this point, anything else is just icing on top, but man. Wow, that is. I've pulled Ultras before, I've pulled Secrets before, but this is my first time ever pulling a Ghost Rare out of a pack. And we had numbers on our side, but still, wow. That is the first time I have ever pulled a Ghost Rare out of a pack. That is just the coolest thing ever. Wow. Gorgeous card. Absolutely phenomenal. I am so incredibly happy about that. That's getting a sleeve. And that one might even be worth putting in the collection right away, but we'll wait just a little while, I think. We'll set it with the Barones. But gosh, isn't that just Wow. It's just that's amazing. That's why we're here today. Gorgeous. All right, that's enough of me gloating. Time to move on. Time to move on to the next ones. And yeah, some of you out there are going to know that Crystal Clearwing is not actually that expensive of a card, but who cares? That it's beautiful. All right, let's see. Man, I still can't get over that. Here we are a couple packs later, and I'm still kind of chuckling to myself. That's a ghost rare, man. That is just the coolest thing in the world. That's just amazing. I'm happy. I'm sure that comes across, but I am just so happy to see it. We might have to clean those up in a little bit. They are trying to get unruly on me. Shoot, there they all go. There they all go. Let's try to reorganize a little bit. I think it's about time that we cleaned up our piles a little bit. I would say that's a fair assessment. Put our rares in the corner there. Our ultras. We've got a nice stack of them going so far. Really nice stack of them going so far. Well, okay, those are also all of our holos, not just ultras, I suppose. But still, very nice. All of my personal favorite cards that we've been pulling. Obviously not the Barones and such of stuff like that, but... Yeah, we're still getting a little bit of fuzz out of these cards when we're just kind of sitting here working them. So yeah, I'm kind of suspicious that any kind of dust showing up is because at the time they were cut, at the time the cards were made, a little bit of dust actually found their way into the cards themselves. I mean, it kind of makes sense if you think about just a factory environment. It's a dusty place, which is a little disappointing if you think about it. That means all your really, really nice copies of cards are still subjected to that sort of treatment from Konami, but, you know, it's still really, really nice what we're seeing on the whole. So I don't think we're in too bad a shape. It's another cube of commons. We've got so many of them pulled right now. Let's just get organized for a second. There we go, looking much better. Nice and neat. Okay. Back to it. Oh, wait, we missed one. All the way out here in the boonies. There we are. Alright, now we can get back to it. We have still got a really long way to go, even this far in. Alright, I don't think I'm going to bother separating out the rares anymore, just for the sake of time. There's another Clear Wing. Love them, love them. One of my personal favorite cards, obviously. Another Clear Wing, gosh, back to back like that. That's awesome. Love that card. Very excited to have it. I think it's a wonderful find. Even though I think it only goes for $3 or $4, but still it's exciting. It justifies the individual pack, right? If you think about it that way. Copy of Chevalier. I just noticed I do actually have a pile of rares set aside, so it's not actually all that much difficulty for me to do that, but another holo. Very nice. We love holos. I love holos. Who doesn't? I know that's such a silly thing to say, like, yeah, we love holos, but, like, you have to think, to a kid, it was just amazing pulling those out, and it's such a cool experience. There we are. There's wheel again. Oh, okay. Had me go in there for a second. It's always exciting to see a synchro monster as the fourth card because all the really big targets are synchro monsters. And definitely that's fun to see. I said I wouldn't separate them, but I guess I'm just being inconsistent at this point. It's a long pack opening. Yeah, might as well actually put them on the common stack then. Well, okay, I guess they both are. Oh, look at me, I'm losing my mind over here. We've still got probably seven or so boxes left to open. Hoping for a couple more copies of Barone, maybe a second ghost. That would be amazing. More holos, always cool. Chevalier. Another bird call. We haven't seen one of those in a little while. They're definitely good cards, though. Love them. Nice. Oh, seeing some synchros in there. And that is another Clearwing Rider. Very nice. Definitely like to see them. There we are, another bird sanctuary. Hey, Clear Wing again. Love it. We've got a couple play sets of them now. Oh, nope. High speed Roy Chambara. They got us this time. Still fun to see. Oh, hey, there we are. There's another Clear Wing Rider. Awesome. Definitely not complaining. Gorgeous cards. I feel like the high rarity cards just look so good on Synchro Monsters because they've got the white backdrop and kind of the same feel. Well, I mean, just kind of the same feeling in general. But just some of these cards, they just look amazing. I see another synchro in there, but yeah, it's not the one we're looking for. Leerlisk Bird Sanctuary. Can't complain. Let me get the rest out here so you guys can see what we're doing. What we've got left to open. There's that. Whoa, 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 whoa. Let's not. That's fine. All right, so this is the rest of the packs. Time to get into it. Don't want to wait at all. I'm very excited to see what we can pull for the rest of this evening. More copies of Barone and more ghosts. That's really what we want to see. Oh, there's a synchro second to left. And that's Barone. Everybody, that is our fourth copy of Barone. Absolutely phenomenal. Absolutely unexpected, Frank. Well, okay, not completely unexpected, but still, when you see something like that, you can't help but be really excited. So that is just phenomenal. That is just amazing. Incredible card, gorgeous printing. I love it. And now we've got four of them. Awesome. All right, moving on. Look at that. I put a couple comments on the trash pile. Oops. I'm sorry. Don't tell Yusei. For those of you who don't know, he constantly said that every card has its value. And if you've seen any Dotodoya recently, shoutouts to them. Very cool content. Yeah, they seem to have the same attitude, which is awesome. All right, let's see. Oh, hey, Clearwing Synchro. We love it. I could open those all day long and be happy. Right there. Let's not get confused. Oh.
Okay. Hey, Clear Wing Synchro. Never gonna complain about that.
I feel like we just broke into a new box. That specific pack had a very different feel to it. Yeah, they're opening a little easier. The cards feel a little more slick somehow. It's an interesting. Gloves are still doing fine. That hasn't changed, but kind of interesting to see. Even though obviously it's kind of hard to see, but I can definitely describe to you that the cards feel just a little silkier somehow. But all like 2 packs ago. That's kind of an interesting observation too. I'm sure that people who've opened a bunch of packs of cards before have noticed not every card is built the same as the next. That's still kind of an interesting observation. You know, I can't pick it up. We're just gonna do that with it. I've got to hurry up before the sun goes down. Another promenade. Promenade. Let's get these out of the way.
Another high speed roid. Chanbara again. We've got about two boxes left, I would say. Somehow we've powered through 15 whole boxes of Yu-Gi-Oh cards, but we're getting closer and closer to the end. Maybe we've seen all the good pulls we're going to get today. Maybe not. Have to hang out a little bit more and find out. Another holo. Very nice. Love to see them. Holos are just cool. I think whoever came up with that idea, they deserve a gold star because that's just awesome. They add so much color to a game that might not otherwise get it. A lot of cards can feel kind of flat, and the holos just conceptually are so cool. All right, we're going to be really schmoovin' through these last few. Another ensemble. Nice. Oh, and another Clearwing Rider. I really, really, really want to be able to find maybe one more Barone. I think that would put us in a good position. Would be very nice to see. Heck, I'm okay with two more, but just the way they've been falling, probably only one left with what we've got on the table right now. Not fumble them too hard. Let's get these guys moved because they are starting to shoot laser beams right into my eyes as the sun's starting to go down. Crazy how fast we've come to this point. Felt like middle of the afternoon earlier, and well, here we are. Push these out of the way because I feel like I'm going to bump into them a lot if I leave them there. So while you won't be able to see the rest of the packs for now, trust me, they're still there. Now trust me, we are going to get through them. Hey, there's another one. Love it. Hey, Stardust Assault Warrior. Very cool. Bird Call. Very nice. Need those. Hey, an unexpected find. I was kind of starting to sign off on the idea of finding any more Barones, but that is a fifth Barone de Fleur. That is an absolutely amazing find. We are very happy to see it. Obviously, that's incredible. Let me find a clear sleeve for them. Show them off a little bit. There we are. There's one more Barone de Fleur. Probably the last one we're going to see. I can't imagine that we're going to get another. But if we did, that would just be amazing. That would make my day. I would be thrilled at that point. So I guess we just have to keep our fingers crossed at this point. Wrong pile. We are really starting to get into the tail end of this, aren't we? Let's see what we can find. Another Necrosynchron. Yep, I was right. I'm not going crazy. You're going crazy. Get out of my head, you crazy thing. Anyway, moving on. White Steed of the Floral. Another Chevalier. So many Chevaliers. 100 million of them, I'm sure. One per pack, it feels like. I mean, obviously not, but one in five, maybe? Not bad odds if that's what you're looking for, but moving on. True Draco Phoenix. I don't know how I hadn't paid attention to that, but Mariana, Mariana, something. Ooh, Brights. I'm sure you guys have been getting even more of it than I have. Zeon. Such a cool card. Or at least in the anime, it was a really cool card. I have absolutely no idea what it does in real life, but it was certainly exciting for Crow and Akiza to have to deal with. More Speedroid stuff. Makes sense. This is a Speedroid set. We should expect only Speedroid stuff, really, but... And Leerlisks, obviously. Kind of a mini set, I would say it was. That seems like when you look at other sets of cards, that they tend to be a lot longer. But I chose this set specifically for Barone. Keep my own copy and probably sell the rest, so be looking forward to that. That means right now we have four copies? They're up for grabs. Should be very cool. All right, let's see. Oh, gosh. That's twice now. I've thrown the commons in the trash pile. Oopsies. Stay. All right. Good. Very last packs. They are officially in the running now. Seems like we've been at this for so long, and yet here we are, actually coming to the end of it. Slowly but steadily, you know. That's the way these things are. Slowly but surely. Get these out of the way real quick. All right. Promenade. Clearwing Synchro Dragon. Nice. Right before we run out of opportunities for it. That is such a fun card. Really is. I just love it. Even if it's not our target card, it's just such a fun find. I just can't complain. High Speedroid Clearwing Rider. You have to get excited with the cards. Yep, come here. Come here, kids. No more running off, will ya? We'll do that just for the rest of them. No more running away. That'd be great. Hey, Fleur de Fleur. Definitely nice. Cobalt Sparrow. And Assault Warrior. Darn. That's always tough when the Synchro Monster is the fourth to bottom. Or is in that especially rare slot. High speed cork. Can't complain. Just another Stardust Warrior. Darn. We're getting jebaited. Nice. Kids. Lego. All right. Chanbaro. They're just all sliding all over the place, huh? Let's make a new pile then. All right, and last stack. We are definitely inside of our last box now. No doubt. Let's see how we do. Crystal, Clear Wings, Synchro Dragon. Nice pull. That warms my heart for that to be in there. That's just exciting. Chances are that's the last really good pull we're going to find. But even so, that's just such a cool find. I'm not even upset. But we're going to power on through this before the sun goes all the way down. Another Chevalier. That's probably the card that I've seen. I can't say that I've seen the most of. I mean, like, obviously, like, Unknown Synchron, Quillbolt Hedgehog, some of the Leerless cards. Like, obviously, that Zone is obviously one that feels like it's been there just a ton of times, but Necroflare, the common. Yeah, because Necroid Synchron, that's the really fancy, the fancy dance one. We're just trying to see if we can't pull one more of our target cards. Either Barone de Fleur or another Ghost Rare Crystal Clearwing Synchro Dragon. Either one of those, and I think we can sign off feeling really good about ourselves. But even so, we've had such a good time pulling cards today. I've really enjoyed myself. Hopefully you guys have too. Let's see here. Leerless Promenade. Very nice. Another Clearwing Synchro Dragon. That's just so cool. Every single time we pull one of those out of a pack, it just feels so good. I love seeing it. One of my favorite cards in the game. I just love it. All right. Only three left. Let's see what you've got inside. Oh, nope, just a Chevalier. That makes sense. All right, second to last one. Again, the Ghost Rare Crystal Clear Wing Synchro Dragon or another copy of Baron de Fleur would be absolutely ridiculous. And it does not look like we've got it in here. But we do have one more pack left. We have one pack left where we could pull either of our two big prize cards. All right, and here we go. These are the last ones out of the set. Two, three, and the last one is a Bird Call. So Bird Call is definitely not a bad pull. Not what we wanted, but it is absolutely a great card. And that's all of it. Those are all the packs. Wow, that took a little longer than I was expecting, but it was definitely a cool pull to review everything that we got. Or if you decided to skip to the end of the video, frankly, I don't blame you. But we happened to pull, let me pull them aside really quick. We managed to pull five copies of Baron de Fleur, which is a card that's going for $130 right now, which is very, very nice. Absolutely love to see those. We pulled one copy of the Ghost Rare Crystal Clearwing Synchro Dragon, which is just amazing. I love this card. This one's going straight in my collection. It's a $30 card, not nearly worth as much as Baron, but it is such a beautiful card and such a cool synchro monster just in general. I don't think there's any way that you could sell it for $30. You'd be crazy, unless you had like 50 of these, right? I mean, at that point, I get it. But this is just such a cool card. That's a miracle to me. And again, that was the first time I have ever pulled one of those. So if we start counting off all of our other cards, I'll make little stacks here off to the side for just a moment. Probably over here though, because if I try to turn that way, the sun's right in my eyes. Anyway, I'll just let you guys count as we go. Not a lot of. Okay, so all the cork shooters are in here. You might see some other high speed roid cards that actually got set in different piles. So that's not a really great count, but all the clear wings, all the crystal wings are in here. Obviously, we pulled a bunch of clear wings. That's really, really cool. Yeah, this guy, Clearwing Rider, I think a couple of them got sorted in a different pile. But with Clearwing Synchro Dragon just being how cool it is, I'm really glad we pulled a bunch of them. And the ultra rare Crystal Clearwing Synchro Dragon to go along with that ghost. I think it's just one of the sickest cards in the game. I love it. It's so cool. But obviously, we pulled a pretty good number of these guys. I am certainly going home happy today. I think that's just so cool. And the rest of it, mostly just commons and rares at this point, so I'm not going to bother going through and doing a full review for all of them. But like I said, from the very beginning, this was 17 boxes. This is the first time I've ever opened so many of these cards before in my life. Frankly, again, I think this is larger than my entire collection was as a kid, and I am so excited to have the opportunity to be able to do this. If you like what you see, like, comment, subscribe, share, do all the junk. This is where I shill. It helps me buy more cards so I can do another video like this at some point if you do all that junk. But either way, I'm just happy that I had this opportunity. I'm really glad to get the opportunity to share it with you all so you can see it too. And I think that'll do it for today. So I had a lot of fun. I hope you did too. I will see you guys in the next video. Goodbye.